Hello everyone and welcome to another AllTrady instruction video. Recently we've added a new version of the trading widget to AllTrady. With this update, we expanded our trading toolset with advanced features. The core of the widget hasn't changed, but it's been redesigned a little. At the top of the widget you can see the order side selection, buy or sell, with balance info related to the selected market pair. Next section is the order type selection, market, limit, and ladder. Market orders allow you to instantly make a trade by buying or selling a specified amount of coins at the next available price of this market. If you want to create a market order only after the market reaches an exact price, you can use stop market type, which adds a stop price input. The stop price inputs act as a trigger, and after the price hits this trigger, a regular market order will be created and executed. The stop price must be above the current market price for buy orders, or below the current price for sell orders. Also, you have to know that market orders are not always the best choice to grow your assets, since prices can change very fast and your orders may be filled with worse prices than you expected. The next order type is limit. It allows you to set a limit or restriction on your order. Placing limit orders would allow you to buy or sell at specified price or better. To add a limit price, you can either type it in manually, select from the price presets, bid, ask, or last, or click on the eyedropper icon and pick the price from the chart. After that, you will be able to drag the price handle on the chart if it needs any price adjustments. The next field is spend, which allows you to specify how much you want to invest in this market. You can use the preset to select the percentage of the available funds. The other option is to specify how many coins you want to buy. You can click on the lock icon to make sure that that amount doesn't move when you alter the price. As you can see, if I drag the price here, the spend amount stays the same. If I change the lock to buy and then drag the price, you can see that the spend amount will change as I move the price up or down. Just like with market orders, you can add a stop or trigger to limit orders. Set your stop price, limit price, spend or buy amount. If you expect the price to drop even more, but you're not sure how far it will go, use the trailing stop order. It allows you to create an order that will follow the price of the market down until it turns around and goes up a set percentage. To set up a trailing stop order, select the trigger price, stop percentage, and the limit percentage. When you create the trailing stop order, the stop limit will only be activated after the trigger price is reached first. OCO, or one cancels the other order, allows you to create two orders, and then after one is executed, the other order will be cancelled. Please keep in mind that this order is currently only available on Binance. Next, you can pick ladder order. It lets you create up to 10 orders at the same time. With scaled ladder, you can set your total position size, the amount of coins you want to spend for all orders, select the start and end price. Set the amount of orders to create in a ladder and pick the price and size scales. There are three options for price scale: linear, exponential, and Fibonacci. For the size scale, we also have three different scales: equal size, linear, and exponential. You can also do linear and exponential in reverse. There is another option to create up to 10 orders, the targets ladder. Specify the position size and set the prices and volume for each target. You can add more targets by clicking the Add Target button. That's it for the entry form. Now we're moving on to the take profit and stop loss options. We've added multiple smart trading options in order to help you automate your trading. Entry order expiration allows you to cancel a position if none of the entry orders were executed within a specified period of time. As most of the orders will keep your coins locked, you can use entry order expiration to unlock your funds automatically if the price is not going your way. Take profit or exit ladder works very similar to the entry ladder, but only sells the coins you've bought before with profit. You can use scale to take profit to exit a position with multiple orders following the selected scales, or use targets take profit to set custom price profit targets. For the take profit price, you can select either a position percentage, which means the actual price will be based on your break-even price, or you can use the fixed price. Fixed price targets will not change after you created them. Profit volume allows you to set how much you want to sell from what you initially bought. 100% volume will sell all your coins you bought for this position. Sometimes you want to keep coins in the base currency, and for that you have to use other profit volume amounts. The next smart order is the stop loss. It lets you exit your position with a loss, to avoid getting into a bigger loss. Stop loss has two types, stop market and stop limit. Stop market orders will sell all your coins as soon as the stop price is hit, against any available price. The stop limit order will create a limit order as soon as the stop price is reached. Please keep in mind that this may result in your coins not being sold immediately. You can set your stop percentage to the desired risk distance. You can also use a stop loss cooldown, which allows the price to dip below the stop loss price for a specific period of time to avoid getting stopped out by some quick drops. Time-based auto close lets you automatically close the position after a specified amount of time, no matter what the price is. Currently, the new take profit and stop loss functions are in beta. If you come across a situation that is unexpected, please report your findings on roadmap.altrady.com under the bug section. Also keep in mind that these extra order types can only be managed within Altrady. Making changes outside of Altrady will lead to unexpected behavior and may break your position setups. We hope you like the new features and please stay tuned for even more trade automation based on the crypto-based scanner trading signals. Alright, that's it for now. See you again later.